Hello everyone, welcome to Steam Train Stories. My name is Miss Barb. I work at the Howard County Library System at the Miller Branch, and this is Mooing Marvin.
Moo, moo!
We're gonna have a super fun time today, Marvin.
Yay!
Today we're gonna discuss shapes.
Woo.
We're going to make balloon powered cars.
Ooh.
Okay, we'll do that at the end. But first, take a look at our steam train. Our steam train has some words on it, Marvin.
Hi.
On the orange cart is the word square.
Square.
Step, very good. Our purple cart has the word rectangle. Can you say rectangle?
Rectangle.
Our green cart has the word triangle.
Triangle.
And our yellow cart has the word circle.
Circle.
Okay. Let's take a look at Mrs. Circle. Mrs. Circle is round and smooth all the way around. She has no corners. She's going to take a ride on the steam train. Which cart should she sit on? She wants to sit on the cart that has her name on it.
I know.
Here you go, Marvin.
Thank you.
Which one?
The circle, yellow.
Okay, the word circle, she'll sit right there. Now here's some items, there are pictures underneath, Marvin. Can you find the circle so they can ride with Mrs. Circle?
The clock.
Very good. The clock doesn't have corners and it's round all the way around. And what else?
A yummy donut.
Good.
It's got two circles.
Yes. She'll hold that one. Okay. Mrs. Circle's all set. Next, we have Mr. Square. Mr. Square has four corners. One, two, three, four. And four sides. One, two, three, four. And all the sides are the same, Marvin. Which color cart is he going to ride on?
He goes in the orange one.
The orange one with square. Now let's take a look at these pictures down here. Do you see anything that has four corners and four sides all the same size?
Yep, the gifts.
Very good. Four corners. One, two, three, four. Four sides that are all the same. They ride with Mr. Square. Okay, one more square.
The window.
Very good. One, two, three, four. And these sides are all the same. Put those with Mr. Square. Our next character is Mr. Rectangle. Mr. Rectangle has four corners. One, two, three, four. And he does have four sides, but they're not all the same size. Which cart should he ride on? What color?
In the purple one.
Okay, we'll put Mr. Rectangle in the purple cart.
He's purple too.
Yes, and do you see any shapes that have four corners, two sides long, and two sides short?
The letter.
Very good. We'll put the letter up there with Mr. Rectangle. And one more shape that can ride with Mr. Rectangle.
I think the door, but it looks weird.
The door has a lot of rectangles in it. It has four corners here. Two short, and two long. But then it has some rectangles inside, too.
Yeah.
There's a lot of rectangles on there. All right. Our last character is Mr. Triangle. What color? He has three corners, one, two, three, and three sides. One, two, three. What color cart should he ride on, Marvin?
In the green one.
Triangle. There we go. All right, and he gets to take one triangle with him. What's left?
The red sign.
The yield sign. The yield sign has one, two, three, corners, and one, two, three sides. So let's put that up there.
Wow.
All right. Our characters look so comfy in Are you ready to use your imagination and build a toy car? Well, we're going to use recycled material. Yes, that's right. We're going to build a trash car.
Trash car!
Yes! And attach a balloon to it and watch it go. So Marvin, why don't you tell us how you made your balloon-powered car?
My trash car?
Mm-hmm.
So I found a box and decorated it with construction paper.
Green.
Mm-hmm. Yep. And then for the wheels, I used Gatorade bottle.
Mm-hmm.
And then the ceiling thing. And then I put eyeballs on them. And I used wiggly eyes to make the eyeballs. And then I used at the top, it's a clear container.
Cool. It looks like a window.
It's like a dome. All
right.
Book.
Let's watch his car. Here we go.
Woo!
Okay. Good job, Marvin.
Yay!
Okay, our next inventor is Gary the Gator.
What's up, dudes?
All right, Gary, why don't you tell us how you made your balloon-powered car?
I love the trash. I mean, my swamp smells like trash. So it's like home to me. And so I found these cool bottle caps right here for wheels.
Mm-hmm.
And then I found this awesome blueberry tub. And that's gonna be my car. And then I found all these sheets of paper. And it's like purple and blue and green and yellow and orange and pink. And it's like a full rainbow.
Cool, Gary.
Let's see it go. Yes. I'm so excited. Mine's gonna go the fastest.
Here we go.
Yes! Totally tubular.
Our next and last inventor is Toby the Dragon. Toby, why don't you describe how you made your balloon-powered car?
Okay, so the first thing you're gonna do, kiddos, is you're gonna find a really long paper towel tube. You're gonna make that the body of your car. And then you're gonna find some water bottle caps, make them your wheels, and find some CDs that don't work no more. Don't use CDs that your mama likes. Gotta use the ones that don't work no more. And then you're gonna make those even bigger wheels so you have extra power. Then you're gonna find your best friend who is a phoenix and steal all of his feathers. And if you don't got a friend who is a phoenix, I feel sorry for you, but you're gonna have to go to the craft store and find some colorful feathers because it doesn't work the same without it. Now, you're gonna blow all the hot air and fire you have into that balloon right there so your car will fly off the handle.
All right, let's try it.
Yeah, let's go. Let's go.
All right, here we go.
Look at those wheels go. Come on, you can go. You can do it.
Gosh darn it.
That was disappointing.
Let's try it again. Ready? Here we go.
All right, this time's gonna be a winner.
There we go. Good job!
You pushed it.
Are you ready to turn your trash into a toy car? Okay, at the end, Miss Barb is gonna have a slide with all the list of materials and step-by-step instructions. So you don't have to worry about, writing everything down. It's gonna be at the very end. Okay, so first you're going to need any four lids, caps, bottle caps. These are water bottles. You can use Gatorade bottles, or if you want to use these and then glue the CDs on, that's fine too. And then you're gonna need two skewers. These are wooden skewers that you find at the grocery store to make kebabs on. So two wooden skewers, and they have to fit inside your straws. So you're going to need three straws, okay? And then you're going to choose the body of your car, which can be anything. I'm gonna use this. It had three tomatoes in it, and I thought that would be pretty cool. It's nice and light. You wanna choose something light because your balloon is giving it power. A water bottle is nice and light and works great. I've tried this before, really good. Okay, this box works. And if you don't wanna see that it's a sandwich box, you can cover it like Marvin with construction paper and then put cool stripes or draw anything you want on it, okay? And when I saw this, this was in a package, I said this would be a cool sunroof on a car. So if you covered this and then put this on the package, it could be a cool sunroof on the car. An egg carton container would be really nice. It's nice and light. You could paint this if you like painting and decorate that. Or here's a piece of foam. I thought that would be cool, a cool car too. This is way too big and way too heavy. So don't use any cheese ball containers, okay? It's just, the balloon's not gonna have enough power to push this. And the straws are too weak to stay on here too. So don't use this. All right, let's move these out of the way. Okay, the first step is you're going to, let's make the balloon. Here's your balloon, and then you're gonna place it on a straw. You don't want to have a bend in it, so this is a bendy straw. I don't want that, so I'm gonna cut that off, okay? And then you're gonna put the opening of the balloon right here and kind of make it nice and tight, because you don't want any air to escape. And you're gonna use scotch tape, pull off a piece, and you're gonna tape it around the ends of the balloon and the straw and make it nice and tight. You're gonna use a couple pieces because you don't want it to slip off and you don't want any air escaping. Do one more. Let's test it and see if any air escapes. Oh, it's got a hole. So Miss Barb has to pull it up and put some more tape around it. Did you see the balloon didn't get big? So it's got a big hole in it. Let me use one more piece of tape. Here we go. Let's try it again. It seems like it's working. It's going very slow because it's a skinny straw. Let's try it one more time. So inside the balloon right now is some potential energy. It's stored in there. It's ready to do something. It's potential energy. When I let go of the straw, it's moving out and it's kinetic energy. Okay, that works pretty good. And it feels, I'm gonna just put one more piece of tape around it just to make sure. All right, so we've got our power. Let's put it aside. Next, we're going to work on decorating our bottle or body of the car. And you saw some really cool suggestions. I decided I wanna use some shapes because we talked about shapes. So I'm using a pink rectangle, a blue square, a purple triangle, and an orange circle. That's gonna be my body. Pretty cool. Next, you're going to need your adult to help you. This is the most important step. You're gonna take your skewers, grown-ups, and you're gonna place it in the middle of the bottle cap and press down. Press down. Put it in the middle. Press down. Put it in the middle. Press down to all four. One, two, three, four. Here we go. Then you're going to take the end that doesn't have the point and stick it, and you kind of move it back and forth very slowly and gently until it pokes through. If it's too wobbly, you might have to get the hot glue gun and glue the outside. Next, we want to make sure that our straws, whoops, my circle fell down. We want to make sure that our straws fit under whatever body you decide. So I'm going to take my straws and make them this big. And they'll stick out a little bit. And I want them to stick out a little bit. Okay? And then you're going to slip the straw onto the wheel like that. And then take the other side with the pointed side and slide it through. Barb needs her glasses. There we go. And then you're going to make sure there's like a little bit of room because you want the wheels to turn. Okay? And that looks perfect. Then I'm going to take my scissors and go around it like that and then break it off. And if your wheel is wobbly, put some hot glue gun. Hot glue out there. So let's make it the next one. We poke this end in. Okay. We drop the straw. And then we poke it through. Make sure that when we hold the center, our wheels turn. And we cut around just like that. And then it breaks off. And there's the wheels. So they should work. We're gonna take the bottom. I'm just gonna put a little bit of tape so my finger doesn't fall off again. Okay. Put the wheels onto the bottom like that. Glue tape. The straw onto the body of the car. You're gonna use a couple pieces of tape. Okay. Let me move everything out of the way. Oh, wait. We need the tape. We've got to put our power on. So I'm going to put it on this side, and I'm going to glue it about, tape it right about here so I can have enough room for my mouth to blow the straw. Here we go. Use a couple pieces of tape again to secure it. All right, let's try it. And that's how you make a toy balloon powered car.